to be delivered.
What kind of eye contact have I used?
To everyone, just like
personal. Right, good, personal. So you all feel that you have that connection with me because I've looked at each one of you individually. I haven't scanned the room. I've made a connection with each one of you. So when you're facilitating, deliberately looking at each person, and I actually move around the room to do that because I'm going to leave someone out if I don't deliberately move around the room to do it. And that's one way to train yourself to start. So you as facilitators, presenters of this material, trainers, whatever we choose to call you, whatever you choose to call yourself, you need to make that eye contact. You will find this challenging when there's somebody scary in the room. You won't want to look at them. You can ignore them. John Borghetti was sitting here now, probably ignore him because you don't want to look at him. They're the people you really want to make eye contact with. So your eye contact is vitally important. What else have I been doing? What else do you think facilitators do?
I think my language. To make sure that people are understanding what you're saying.
Okay, so how am I doing that?
By looking at their body language and their reaction to you.
Yes, okay, so I'm engaging that.
Check it for understanding as you go.
Yes, so I'll check it for understanding. What am I saying?
Have I explained that clearly?
Okay, good.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, okay, so well done. You've remembered the words that I've said there. What's the difference between those words and me saying to you, do you understand that?
It's a close question that you get a yes or no.
Yeah, it's a bit more than that. So I said, can I explain that, okay?
It's kind of like you're putting it back on yourself.
Exactly.
Rather than us feeling like we didn't get it.
Yeah, you're an idiot. You
yeah.
You understand. Yes, yeah, so that's your fault. Can you see the difference there? This helps you establish rapport very quickly. So checking understanding is another way. And when you check understanding, you take responsibility for it. And it's so important when you deliver this material because you're not just a presenter. What else do you think you might be? You're a teacher, yes, what else? A role model, absolutely. So you have to, you're grooming, your standards have to be absolutely meticulous, particularly with the Elevate program, because we're trying to elevate our service, elevate our success, elevate our grooming, bring it up a notch. So it's absolutely vitally important that you're able to do that. Any other comments? Is there anything else that I've just done now? Doing is you're modeling the change that Virgin Blue wants to go through. You are very powerful in empowering our people now. You have such a real key role in making this change happen. So you're like change agents, you're comedians. It's a very important job that you have. If you can grab the art of facilitation and really start using it, you'll have a fantastic career in this area, as well as what you're doing. So it just opens up so many more doors. Okie dokie, is there anything else to add to this that you guys can think of?
For me, I think with groups, particularly when we have one whole day of training, is more around the state of a room. So knowing the state that the group is in, and sometimes a quick state can change. So that's the only thing aware. Some people just ignore it or don't even see it because you're so wrapped up in your own facilitation and everyone else is just switched off. And there's no point carrying on until the room are engaged again, so which I know comes to activities, but it's just being aware of the state.
Yeah. If your group's not engaged, who has to take responsibility for that? If you go into a training environment, today's going to be a disaster. I didn't have enough sleep last night. Auntie Mary rang up and I really didn't want to talk to her. I've got this group from Melbourne and they're always awkward and I'm just really not in the mood for it. If you you go in with that mindset, what's your likely outcome? It will be, yeah. And even now, sometimes I don't feel like doing it. But if I look at myself in the mirror in the morning, I think, oh, for God's sake, I've got to do that bloody training again. I really don't want to do it. It's that group I have it on. Or if I tell myself that and then I stop, I think, well, what are you doing? So I look in the mirror and I say, today's going to be good. It's going to be a challenge. It's not going to be difficult. Get rid of that word. It's going to be a challenge. But I'm going to have fun. They're going to learn lots. I have lots of interaction. I'll get some interesting questions, but that's okay. I'm prepared. And we'll get through the day and we'll have a positive outcome. And then I do have that outcome. So a lot of it's what you think in your mind. So going back to what Gaynor said, the state of the room, if the energy levels are low, you need to pump your energy up. If they're looking like they're very tired, then you need to think, okay, they need a break. Don't have breaks every 10 minutes, obviously, but you have to judge as a facilitator what's happening. Change the pace, change your tone of voice, different activities, some of the things we talked about. Anything else you want to add? Now, I've got some experts in the room here, so I'm using them. And you will have some people in your room who may know more than you. Is that okay? Yeah. To your advantage. Don't be terrified because you've got some really senior person sitting in the room. It's okay. You're not expected to know everything that possibly is about Elevate, but you know enough to meet the outcomes, the objectives of the session that you're running. If you don't know the answer to something, what do?
Admit you don't know.
Yeah. What you can do is value what that person said, first of all. So that's a really good question that you asked. I'm not sure of the answer to that. I'll find out and come back to you. Does that sound okay? Value what you get. So if you thank people for their contribution, what does that do?
Makes them feel like they're
part of
it.
Yeah, they feel they're part of it.
Oh, I know. I might, you know, they might not have thought of that.
Yeah.
So I've added some input.
Absolutely. So rather than you go, oh, no one's ever asked me that before, and I'm really sorry, but I don't think I know. Yeah, it's a bit embarrassing, but I don't know. But anyway, I'll see what I can do and find out. Just join your credibility. Honestly, that's a really good point. I hadn't thought of that, but I'll find out and come back to you. That's fine, isn't it?